Thank you for taking on the responsibility of becoming a guardian. New guardians often have many questions regarding their duties and authority. The Vernon County Bar Association developed the following video through a grant from the State Bar of Wisconsin to help answer some of the most frequently asked questions of new guardians. In this video, you will meet John, a newly appointed guardian, and his wife Marcia, as they encounter some of the more common issues that confront newly appointed guardians. Following each vignette, the Honorable Michael J. Rossborough, Vernon County Circuit Court Judge, will provide analysis and explanation of how John could have appropriately handled each situation.
How's it coming on those bills, Marcia?
It's going okay, but I have these bills for your mom's expenses.
Oh, I've just been paying for them out of our account. I have her Social Security money directly deposited to us, then pay her bills out of that account. It's a lot easier than dealing with all that other stuff.
I don't know, John. That doesn't seem quite right. Maybe you should go down to the bank and get her her own account.
A guardian is sometimes also referred to as a fiduciary. That is, someone who has the legal authority and duty to make financial decisions on behalf of another. A guardian should never put the ward's money and his or her own money in the same account. John should set up a separate fiduciary account for his mother's funds and pay all of her expenses from that account. This separate account is to be used only for his mother's benefit.
Hey, Marcia, have you seen my mom's checkbook anywhere?
Oh, I haven't seen it since we went clothes shopping. Oh, wait, I think I put it back in the drawer with their other papers.
Oh, there it is.
Why do you need it?
They're having a sale on big screen TVs at the store. Mom would love to come over and watch the Packers on big screen TV.
You're going to use her bank account for that? John, I've been thinking about the whole big screen TV thing. I don't know if you should be using your mom's money for that.
Yeah, that might not be right. But I know Mom would want me to have something like that, you know? It would be like a gift from her.
She hasn't been able to buy you anything in a long time, and you certainly don't get anything out of all the work you do for her. I don't know. I'm still uneasy about it.
Yeah. But wouldn't that TV be nice?
In these two vignettes, John attempts to justify the purchase of the television using his mother's funds, and he has all sorts of rationalizations as to why this is appropriate. John, however, is not authorized to use his mother's funds or property for his own benefit on grounds that his mother would agree to it if she were competent, and the court would never approve a request that he be allowed to do so. His mother's funds must be used to pay her debts and expenses and for such purposes as would be in her best interests, not John's. A ward's past history of gift-giving is never a justification for the guardian to give away the ward's money or property.
What you got there, Marcia?
Oh, just an old picture I found of your mother. She looks so happy in this picture.
She sure does. I wish she could be that happy again.
When was the last time you went to see her?
Oh, I think it was Christmas.
John, that was months ago.
I know, but it's just not pleasant being with her.
I know, but as guardian, don't you have to see her more often?
While it may not be pleasant for John to experience the decline in his mother's health in a care facility setting, he assumed the duty to visit her regularly when he agreed to be her guardian. He has a duty to have regular contact with his mother in order to assess her condition, surroundings, and treatment. As part of this duty, he must inquire about, attend, and participate in facility meetings where her care needs are discussed.
Hey, John, did you see this?
See what?
You got something from probate court, probably something about your mom.
It says condition of the ward with a whole bunch of questions. Blah, blah, blah. This looks like a lot of work.
If it's from court, you better get it done quick.
Why do they need all this? Mom's doing okay. I'll get to it later.
John, as his mother's guardian, is required to make an annual report on the condition of his mother to the court and to the County Department of Human Services or another agency designated by the court. This report updates the court and the department on the location of his mother, the health and condition of his mother, any recommendations that John may have regarding his mother, and a statement as to whether or not his mother is living in the least restrictive environment consistent with her needs.
Hi, hon, what are you doing?
Remember that letter from probate about taking mom's inventory? I'm just getting through her junk box. This is gonna take forever.
Are you sure you have to do all that?
John must file an inventory with the court within 60 days of his appointment as guardian. An inventory is a list of property that his mother owns along with the fair market value. While the inventory must list all property of monetary value, common sense applies, and it is not necessary to account for every item of nominal value. For example, it would be satisfactory in this scenario for John to include an entry for clothing along with a good faith estimate of the value of his mother's clothing.
Say, I got another phone call from my brother.
Yeah, what did he have to say?
The usual. He keeps wanting to buy the farm from Mom.
Oh, what's wrong with that?
Well, now he wants to buy it at half its value.
Well, that seems a little low. I know your mom wants to keep the farm in the family, but aren't there some type of rules on setting the price? This might be a good time to call the guardian ad litem.
Yeah.
Authority of the court is required for the sale of all real property owned by a person under guardianship. Generally speaking, the court will not approve a sale of real property for less than fair market value, even if that sale is to a family member. Remember, John's mother's assets are to be used for her care, and accordingly, John, as her guardian, has a duty to maximize the assets of the guardianship estate.
It's a brochure for our trip to Spain. What do you say we go for 3 months this year?
Well, what about your mother?
As guardian, I can put her in the nursing home's care while we're gone.
For 3 months? I thought the guardian ad litem had to be involved.
Nah, as mother's legal guardian, I can handle that myself.
This scenario illustrates two issues. First, a guardian should not confuse his or her role with that of a guardian ad litem. A guardian ad litem is an attorney who is appointed by the court to represent the best interests of the ward during court proceedings. A guardian is an individual who is court appointed to manage the daily affairs of an incompetent person and make important decisions about matters such as finances and health care. Second, as guardian, John cannot simply assign or transfer his decision-making authority to another person or the nursing home during an extended absence. John must either make suitable arrangements to be accessible during his overseas trip, or he must ask the court to appoint another guardian in his absence.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. Mom seemed to be kind of out of it, as if she'd had an overdose of her medication.
Did you ask the nurse about it?
Yeah, and he said Mom needed more to reduce her anxiety. I guess medical people know best.
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this. I know your mom hates to take any drugs she doesn't have to.
I'm not sure we can do anything about it.
John has a duty to inquire into the risks and benefits of his mother's treatment and consult with providers of health and social services in connection with treatment decisions regarding his mother. If John feels that his mother's current medications or treatment are not in her best interest, he has a duty to consult with the medical providers about his concerns and to get additional opinions if he is not satisfied with the responses he is receiving.
Do you need any help with the annual report form, hon?
No, I think I have it almost done.
Did you get all the accounting information from the nursing home since our last vacation?
No, not really. They handle her expenses directly. Why do I have to account for them?
I thought I read something about that in the guardianship papers.
Well, I think this is good enough to turn in. I don't want to bother at this late date.
John has a duty on an annual basis to report all of his mother's income, expenditures, and the current value of all of her assets, regardless of who actually handled the expenses. In this instance, John has a duty to get the financial information from the nursing home so that he can provide a full and accurate report to the court.
Okay, I'll think it over and get back to you. Goodbye.
Who's that, hon?
It's my brother, Paul. He and Joni both think we should transfer Mom to the nursing home on the east side of town. They think this new one is too fancy and expensive.
But your mother toured both of them and she prefers the one she's in now. It's non-restrictive and she has friends there. The older one is so dingy and they operate it like a prison.
I know, but Paul can be so insistent on not wasting our inheritance, as he puts it. I really want to get him off my back, but I don't know what to do.
John's duty as guardian is to do whatever is in his mother's best interest, regardless of the cost or impact on his, or in this case, his brother's inheritance. It would not be in his mother's best interest to move her from a suitable and affordable facility, one where she is comfortable and has friends, to a cheaper or substandard facility just to save money.
And that concludes our presentation. We hope that this video will be helpful in guiding you as you endeavor to meet the best interests of your ward. Thank you. We'll be right back.